story of George Steinbrenner and Billy Martin is the story of what happens when an unstoppable force meets an immovable object. George Steinbrenner, nicknamed the Boss, was known as a, let's say, hands-on owner. He used to call the dugout and affect on-field decisions, and he was notorious for firing and hiring managers. Over his tenure with the Yankees, George Steinbrenner changed managers 21 times, even firing and rehiring several managers over and over again. Lou Piniella, Gene Michael, Bob Lemon, and Dick Houser all managed the Yankees twice under Steinbrenner's ownership, but that was nothing compared to Billy Martin. Billy Martin was a brash second baseman known for his sense of humor, also his temper, and also his extreme baseball knowledge. He was known for taking bad teams and turning them into contenders. He had managed the Twins, Tigers, and Rangers before his first stint with the New York Yankees. During that stint, he notoriously did not get along with Reggie Jackson, the superstar of the team, and even tried to fight him in the dugout. Billy took over as manager of the Yankees in 1975, and he guided the team to a 30-26 record. In 1976, he took the Yankees all the way to the World Series, where they were swept by the Big Red Machine. That winter, Billy lobbied against the signing of brash superstar Reggie Jackson, whom Steinbrenner wanted to sign to put in the number 4 spot of the lineup. And what George wants, he usually gets. But Billy refused to bat him fourth for much of the season, causing a lot of tension between Billy Martin and George Steinbrenner. This story is depicted quite well in the ESPN series, The Bronx is Burning. Anyway, Reggie hit 3 home runs in Game 6 of the World Series, and the Yankees were World Series champions. Billy Martin, though, was fired halfway through the 1978 season. Martin was rehired halfway through the 1979 season after George Steinbrenner was disappointed with the performance of manager Bob Lemon, but then he was fired after the season after beating up a marshmallow salesman to win a $500 bet. I wish I was making this up. He was then hired and fired during the 1983 season and then managed the team in 1985 and 86 when the team was pretty good but failed to make the postseason. He then was hired and fired again during the 1988 season, and the Yankees began their downward slide. On Christmas of 1989, Billy Martin was actually in talks to manage the Yankees for a 6th time when he was tragically killed in a drunken driving accident. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. It helps other Yankees fans find the channel.